Okay, so one thing I thought would be a good idea would be to make a list of topics of things I want to talk about in a commentary and put this list of topics in Notepad and make it visible while I do the commentary and then just ramble on about these certain topics as I do the commentary. And we're going to try it. Another thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start naming the videos after the things. Like the random topics I list out and such. And it should be funny. If not funny, it should get attention and views and such. So yeah, first thing on the list here, the recording series. The season finale of that was just posted. I'm taking a little break to recharge my batteries and such. So don't ask me about it. Because if you have to ask, the answer is always no. I think we all know that by now. So if you ask me, hey, when will the next such and such be posted? I will say no. That is your response. No. No. Now. No. Nada. Okay. Now that we got that out of the way, let's get to the meat and potatoes of this list. Children's toothpaste. I recently purchased some children's toothpaste at the grocery store. Two different kinds, actually. And I don't know why it's children's toothpaste because it tastes really good. I kind of want to eat it, but I know if I eat it, I'll probably die. Another topic, real quick, is when I was a kid, I used to like the taste of toothpaste, children's toothpaste. I used to swallow it, and my parents never told me different. You can call that bad parenting, or you can call that me being a stupid kid, but I used to swallow that toothpaste every time after I'd brush my teeth. And I don't know, I'm surprised I'm not dead now. Maybe that's why I'm kind of short. Like maybe it's none of my growth or something. I don't know. But children's toothpaste tastes really good. Like I got this kind that's like fruity bubblegum flavored, and then I got like it's like Buzz Lightyear fruity bubblegum. And I also got this like natural toothpaste with orange, it's like orange stuff, and it's so good. I just want to eat the whole tube. Just want to nom on the tube. Nom, 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 nom. But as I said, I'd probably die, and I don't really want that. But why did we ever like what? Why as adults do we have to start using toothpaste that tastes like butthole and burns your mouth? Why not just use the bubblegum, fruity bubblegum flavored toothpaste? Because it doesn't, I mean, it tastes good. And it doesn't burn your mouth. But, I mean, I don't really know. I don't have the answers. It's the same reason we go from eating, like, Lucky Charms to eating Cheerios with no sugar. Because we get old and stupid and we eat, like, lard-dipped Oreos all our lives and we have bad cholesterol by the time we're 30 or something and then Cheerios marketing campaigns like, well, if you eat Cheerios with no sugar, your cholesterol will go down. And that's a bunch of bullshit. I don't believe that at all. Maybe it's true. I don't know. Just like, I don't know. Eat Cheerios with something unhealthy and balance it out. Does it work that way? Like Cheerios, like Cheerios treats, like Rice Krispies treats? I don't know. But let's move on to another topic. Censorship. In particular, internet censorship. So I uploaded a video of Vietnamese Crystal, and it was a really funny video, I thought. And I said some things that at the time I didn't think anything of. I thought they were funny, and I think other people thought they were funny too. But I guess YouTube didn't think it was too funny because like somebody flagged it or something. And usually flagging does nothing, but I guess somebody at YouTube really doesn't like the RAP. You can say the last letter if you want. I'm scared to say it, man. I'm scared to say it. I guess they don't like that word. I guess I also said something about ejaculating on something's. You know what? I also said the FA. GG no reword. I'm scared to say these words and phrases. I said these words, and I don't know. I don't understand, like, where it became common practice to be so, like, politically correct and super non-offensive and stuff. Because I remember back in the day, man, there were these shows I used to watch on Nick at Night as a kid. Has some really, like, the best sitcoms ever. The best sitcoms ever. Because they were controversial, and they didn't take shit, and they said what they wanted, and they were funny. And there are two sitcoms in particular that I think are the best sitcoms to ever be produced. And those two sitcoms are All in the Family and Sanford and Son. And they both were fairly similar shows in that the main characters were lovable, like, bigots, you know? They didn't like, I mean, they could say, like, racial remarks and stuff. And one was white on one show and one was black on the other show. So it was all cool, I guess. It didn't matter back then in, like, the 70s. It was cool. And they could be racial and it was funny. You know what I mean? I don't know what happened there. I just, like, fucking lagged behind a car. But it was funny. And I'm just thinking, like, sitcoms today suck butt, man. They suck butthole. They really do. They suck. Like, the last sitcom I can remember remotely enjoying in this modern day and age is that 70s show. I'm not a huge fan of that 70s show. It's pretty fun. Funny, I should say, not fun. Look at this. I'm an idiot. Why did I miss that? I missed still targets and I hit moving shots. Hit her that time, though. Spanky Peterson. Okay. But, you know, it's just, that 70s show is pretty good. Seinfeld, I like Seinfeld too. But Seinfeld's kind of old at this point. But it seems like after the early 80s, I think the last sitcom that came out that I liked was Taxi. Big fan of Taxi. Love me some Taxi. But, you know, even that was less racist, bigoted. But it was still a really good sitcom. Really funny. Had a lot of good messages. Sitcoms today, man, I don't know. I don't want to offend anybody's taste, but I watched some sitcoms and I'll just be like, man, what? Like, how is this even funny? But if people, I mean, I don't know. It's just this day and age thing. It's like, I feel like an old man, like, back in my day, we, blah, blah, blah. I don't want to sound like that, so whatever. So what else we got here on the list? Oh yeah, well, another thing about censorship before I got off the topic. My Xbox Live account got banned. And you know why? Because in the bio, I had the phrase, and this is quoted, "Pardon my tits." Now, I don't know. I read the little, you know, terms of use thing. I don't really see how this is a bannable offense, because it's not like it's sexual. I mean, everybody has tits. It's like, I feel like I could get banned if I said, "Pardon my butt." I seriously want to put, like, when my account gets unbanned, I seriously want to put, "I love Dick Cheney," and see if they do anything. I feel like if my name was Dick Slaps a Lot, or something, like, if that was my real legal name, I couldn't put it in Xbox Live without getting terminated, banned, whatever. And I'm sure, like, maybe I could have some kind of, like, lawsuit case or something if it's something like I put, "I enjoy the company of men," or something, and they ban me for that. Because I think a friend of mine got banned for that, actually, one time. I'm pretty sure that I can make a case out of that. But I'm too lazy. So they're lucky I'm so lazy. Either way, it's bullshit, man. First Amendment. I mean, I know it's a private service, and you gotta agree to their terms of use, but First Amendment rights, man, as long as you're not attacking some religion, race, whatever, you know, it should be fine. Pardon my... this makes me mad. Pardon my tits. Come on. Pardon them. I guess in this instance, they weren't pardoned. So anyway, what else? The next topic on the list is things that piss me off. Now, there are three things that piss me off. I could be having the best day ever. I could win $1 million. I could get laid like 10 times. I could poop a gold egg. And these three things would manage to piss me off. And these three things are technology not working properly as it should. I hate that more than anything ever. Hate it. Makes me so mad. So, you know, people will be like, dude, stop criticizing YouTube. But for you people that don't upload, you don't know how frustrating YouTube can be. You gotta upload the video. Pray the upload doesn't fail throughout the upload, because it's been doing that a lot lately, and it's not my connection. You gotta pray it uploads, pray it processes properly, and pray it publishes properly. And these three things have, like, maybe a 60-50% chance of working. It is incredibly frustrating. I'm actually gonna... You know, I was gonna set this video to upload and use a scheduled uploader, but I know as soon as I take my eye off this upload, this video right here, it's probably gonna freeze. And it's on my internet, because I can play Xbox Live just fine. I can do everything just fine, except upload to YouTube. I don't know why. And it wasn't this way, like, a month ago. It just kind of happened. But yeah, technology not working properly. Human stupidity. Stupidity just makes me so angry. And I don't know. I think that's just a given, though. Like, ignorance, stupidity, and people in general being mouth breathers. It's just kind of... I mean, I guess people can't help it. That's something I shouldn't get pissed off at, but I do. I actually kind of forget the third thing. I think it's like, I don't know. I can't even remember. You know what? It'll come to me if it pisses me off, and I'll say it in a future video. But the last topic on the list is my personality and how reflective it is. I have a very reflective personality. I've seen people call me a super nice guy. I've seen people call me an asshole. But I don't want to be called either of those things. I want to be called fair, because that's what I feel I am. Because I will act in a way that I'm treated. If you're nice to me, I'll be so nice to you back, man. You don't even know. If you're a dick to me, I'm going to be a bigger dick back. If you're neutral to me, I'll be neutral back. That's pretty much how it is, you know. I try to be nicer, though, to everybody, but it's hard sometimes, especially with those two things that piss me off, because those things happen very often. And yeah, I need to work on controlling that anger. But hey, that's the end of the game. Final score is 14-3. I hoard that boom shot. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. Rate the video and such. Bye.